Let's talk some Venusaur ecology. Venusaur is probably actually a terrifying predator. Its Pokedex reads that it remains still a lot of time and relies heavily on the photosynthesis that the plant on its back can provide. It also says that the plant attracts other Pokemon to it by its sweet scents. And an animal that's shaped vaguely like this, the Pac-Man frog, is a voracious predator and eats pretty much anything that comes in front of it. Which begs the question, what is Venusaur eating? Most frogs only have teeth in the roof of their mouth, like this frog, and some frogs don't have any teeth at all, like true toads. If Venusaur ate more plant material, we would expect to see some of the grinding teeth in its mouth. Like if you look at herbivores, they have a bunch of molars, whereas stuff like frogs and amphibians can get away with having really tiny teeth or no teeth at all. Researchers in a study on frog teeth actually found a correlation between the lack of teeth and a diet of really tiny insects. If your prey is really small and easy to crush, you probably don't need teeth to help, but if you're eating something more substantial, that might require some teeth to aid in the process. And in Venusaur's case, we have a couple of fangs, which might just be to help hold on to prey a little. Basically, all amphibians that I can think of off the top of my head have to rely on eating other animals to exist, which in general is called hypercarnivory, which just sounds awesome. So I think Venusaur is pretty much just sitting around in the most comfortable spot, using its plant to attract Pokemon to it, and then crams it in its mouth and basically swallows it whole. It's going to be consuming a lot of insects and other arthropods, maybe some like snails and crayfish, stuff like that. But if prey densities are low, it can make up some of that calorie deficit with photosynthesis from the plant on its back. This is a symbiotic relationship in which the plant gives Bulbasaur oxygen and some energy, and Bulbasaur protects it from predators and supplies it with nutrients. If Venusaur is a scientific name, since it has "saur" in the ending like many dinosaurs, does that make it a dinosaur? There are actually a lot of organisms that have the ending of "saur," which does mean lizard, in their name even if they aren't lizards or dinosaurs. There's ichthyosaurs and mosasaurs, which are marine reptiles but not dinosaurs. And then you have things like anteosaurs, which is actually a therapsid, which is a precursor to mammals. Venusaur is probably a poke anuran, so it's going to be related to things like polyrath and Greninja. So the naming of Venusaur might be a mistake if this thing actually is more amphibian-like, but the suffix of "saur" doesn't always mean it's a dinosaur. Thanks for watching, and follow for more Pokemon Ecology.